campus for the whole enchilada. I'll stake my reputation on it. You need to cut them off and eat them alive. Smitty, you should be looking your shop. You're bigger than these shrimp. The attack has got to be the mini. Defense, poke them in the ribs, carve them up like a piece of meat, they're chicken. Okay, here they come. Pass it around. That's the way to go. Come on, guys. Now you're doing a great job. Cut it up. Slice it up. Eat them up.
We're here at Loyola College, the Evergreen campus, prior to the start of today's North Carolina Tar Heel Loyola College game. Pleasure to talk with the 10th year head coach, Dave Cottle of the Loyola Greyhounds. Tough to say 10 years, Dave, hard to believe.
Yeah, it is hard to believe, Howard. I started here, I guess it's 11 years now. I started here in 1982, and this is our 12th season, and we've come a long way, but we've got a long way to come.
A lot of players graduated from last year's team. Kevin Beach, of course, and you got to replace a lot of your offensive stars. How do you look at the attack this year?
Well, we're a completely different team than last year. Last year we had Kevin Anderson, Paul Canabin, and Kevin Beach guys. Three guys that did a lot of our scoring. I think we're a little more unselfish than we were last year because we don't have that dominant player. Sean Heffernan, Derek Radibal, Kevin Lutz, Emphon Udo, and Kevin Haynes. We're going to play five attacks in today, and they're a young group, but their group is playing pretty well together.
You're looking for Tim McGee to regain his freshman form.
No doubt about that. What you said is very important. Regain his freshman form. I thought we had a sensational year as a freshman. Last year as a sophomore, had a good year. We need him to get back to that his first year.
Well, if you recall going back to 1990 when you took on Syracuse for the national championship, your team had a type of quality looking at this 1994 season.
Yeah, I didn't think so. I'm not sure what kind of team we have. I've never gone into a big game like today and had more question marks about a team than I have in this one. I think we're a team that's playing pretty well together. But I don't think we have great individuals, so I think the sum of our parts is a little better than their individual guys.
Four consecutive quarterfinals for the Loyola team, and then, of course, in the last 6 years, you made it to the playoffs. How do you look offensively? I read where you'd like to keep it in single digits, so is defense going to be the name of the game for Loyola this season?
I think the most consistent part about our team is defense, and we need to get to double digits in order to be an effective team against the type of teams we play. We really don't know about our offense. We're doing some new things. We scored quite a bit of goals last weekend. We're improving, but that's really a question mark for us.
Today, it's the North Carolina Tar Heels. What can you tell us about their ball club under Dave Klum? And, of course, they lost last week to Syracuse, so now you got an opportunity to make it 2-0, first time ever in the Klum and coach team that lost 2-0, if you're able to upset them this afternoon.
Well, they have four middies that are outstanding, Drew Collins, John Spears, and the Wade brothers, and they're the key to their offense. In the goal, they have Gary Lehrman and Rocco DeAndreas, two outstanding goalies. Defensively, Chuck Brush is a real key. It's a real key to be face-offs, and if we can control the ball and set the tempo. They're going to come out flying after their loss to Syracuse. We can't let them jump all over us early because they'll set the tank. We need to control the ball, make them play defense, and take the edge off, and then play a four-quarter game.
Loyola College wins a 34 out of the last 40 played here at Curley Field. Best of luck to you, Dave Cottle, in today's game. Now we'll be back with more pregame commentary from beautiful Evergreen campus here at Loyola College in Baltimore, Maryland.
Who's going to do that? She's a mind of the other, but no, she's a mind. him.
Nobody needs the food.
Remember family affair.
What's that friend?
He loves you.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe coffee.
Pink, blue, blue. And not blue. Okay, Ginger or Mary Ann? Mary Ann.
Today we're going to take a look at some face-off techniques, I guess, for you in this afternoon. So, let's get to Michael.
Baltimore's number one store for minivans.
For price
and selection.
Look at this equipped Voyager deal.
It's Sundance deal.
And it's loaded.
And stop. Don't pay $22,000 for your Concours.
Take price just $18,995.
And now the all-new Plymouth Neon is gassed up and ready to go.
Take Chrysler Plymouth, Glen Burnie.
Nobody has what Kate has.
Take a look at the starting lineup. First of all, for the young North Carolina team, the lineup on attack with Greg Langhoff. He's 6'1", 185.
him. It'll be Ryan Wade, who is their leading scorer, a senior out of Davidson, Maryland, along with Tobin and his brother John Wade. And on defense, it'll be Driver Fox, and rushing and in the net will be Rocco D'Andrea, who is a junior, a transfer from Rutgers out of Yorktown Heights, New York, in Yorktown High School. And for Loyola, they'll line up with their leading scorer, Sean Heffernan, a senior, 5'6", 155 out of Coxville. Lutzen Radabaugh completes the attack in midfield. It'll be Batso, Swan, and Howard A. And on defense, Fry, Foley, and Wilson. And in the net will be the junior, Tim McGinney, trying to regain his form as a freshman. He sparkled and gained honorable mention. Last year, a little bit of an offseason for McGinney, and they need a lot of help defensively. As head coach Dave Cottle would like to see a low-scoring game. Carolina was down by only one goal going into the fourth quarter, but they take that. Telltale Road, and this is the road team, as we mentioned, for North Carolina. They return only two of the 10 starters and 19 of the 34 Lettermen off of last year's team. And out of the faceoff will be Brendan Carey for North Carolina. Or check that. For North Carolina, out of the faceoff will be their stellar faceoff man, Ryan Wade, who's a senior out of Davidson, Maryland. And for the Loyola Greyhounds, Brian Batso, a sophomore from doubleheader here in Loyola and North Carolina, trying to avoid back-to-back losses for the first time since 1977. Never in the history of fourth-year head coach Dave Swanden have they faced a defeat twice in a row. This is a big gun for North Carolina. Keep an eye on number 19, Ryan Wade, out of Davidsonville. This is Carey. Carey plays it out on top. They like to slow it down. Wade, the brother of number 19, 43-19, the brother Tannum, out on top. And as we mentioned, we're all over line on defense, and they need a big-time game out of their last line of defense, Tim McGinney.
We're going to have a flag. It's going to be a flashing violation against Loyola. So North Carolina's going to have a man-up opportunity for a minute. Last week in Carolina's game against Syracuse, they did not do particularly well in their man-up situations. They were 1-for-14, so that's an area that they've spent some time in practice.
Tar Heels looking for their 15th consecutive trip to the NCAA tournament. And under head coach Dave Tyler of Loyola, they made it 4 consecutive years to the semifinals in the tournament play the last 6 years. The overall record for Loyola here is fairly failed. 34-5. Talking about the home field advantage. Loyola last year beat Syracuse. The game will be televised across the country. Good perimeter passing for North Carolina. A lot of patience. You watch Wade. Gets it off to Carey. Here's Wade. Played over to Drew Collins, a sophomore out of Alexandria. They look for somebody slanting in, but the pass eluded Wade. And it goes across the far sideline. And the threat of the defense on the part of Loyola. Greyhound stops the first offensive rush with the extra man on the part of North Carolina. 13:48 left in the first quarter with scoring.
Excellent defense by Loyola. Packing. Tighten their zone defense around Tim McGinney. The defensive coordinator is Dave Petromala, a Hopkins graduate and one of the best defensemen in history of Fort LaFrance.
Last year, North Carolina was undefeated at home. On the road, they only faced the defeat twice. The ball is knocked out of bounds. Good deal on the part of North Carolina, and it'll gain them possession.
Carolina is known for their ride or forecheck. And that time, Loyola failed to clear the ball. It's going to be a key to today's game. If Loyola can advance the ball from defense to offense.
Dave Swanden's overall record, 42-6. And this is the fourth season at the helm of the Tar Heels. It'll be over for Willie Schwab. Carolina Blue out of the Atlantic Coast Conference. Perennially in the Final Four. Dave Cottle would like to see this game in low digits. All right, this is Steve Collins, number 46. He leaves Uno in his wake, and let's go a shot that appeared to hit the pipe from a tough angle.
Nice move by Collins, showing his quickness. Last year, Collins didn't see much action until late in the season and had a great Final Four. Why right there?
Collins is a sophomore out of Alexandria, Virginia.
Much of quick change of direction, fake right, brings the ball back in his left hand. Didn't have much angle, but Dean's cutting down the pipe there.
But Jason Foley defensively, along with Brendan Fry, a sophomore at the first time, correct? The Titans. Oh, and taking over midfield for the first time. John Spears out of Fayetteville, New York, brings it right back to North Carolina. Metro Texas League, along with Buffy, West Tennessee, the early in New York. Now Foley takes it up, and again, North Carolina applying some early pressure as Duke Collins has it. Collins from Durkee in his shot. And McGee coming up big time. Early on in this one with 12-12 left in the first quarter. We're still scoreless from John M. Phillips Field. The Evergreen Panthers here in Baltimore, Maryland.
Good save by McGee there, deflecting the ball over the net. Loyola having a lot of problems cleaning the ball right now. They failed to clear three times in a row.
Ryan Duffy has got it, and finally going into the fact that Sean Heffern would be the Iowa number three. A senior leading scorer out of Delaney and Essex Community College here by Cottonville, Maryland. The outskirts of Baltimore. Excel Holliday, a senior out of Lambert, Victoria, British Columbia, and a few Canadian players playing Division I lacrosse. Kevin Lutz, Boyd Latin of Javisville, Maryland. A low-scoring game, very much to the advantage of Loyola, according to head coach Dave Cottle in his 11th year at the helm of the Greyhounds. You got to watch Heffernan, he's 5'6". And of course, he's being met defensively by the taller and bigger defenseman. That's John Fox, a freshman from Stony Brook, New York.
And a score, Loyola, with a 34 and 5 overall record, open up with a 1-0 lead over North Carolina, and we'll be back.
For the creators of the game, it was more than competition. It was a ritual of the spirit. For those who take the game seriously, there is only one place for stick with custom designed and engineered pockets, protective equipment, team apparel, sportswear, custom clothing, and specialty items. Allman Sports International. Visit our extensive showroom at 7 West Aylesbury Road in Pomona. We take the game seriously.
You want the best for your money.
You're simply the best!
And now you can drive a dependable Toyota Tercel at a bargain price. With a small down payment, you can lease a Toyota Tercel for just $129 a month through a special new plan from Toyota Motor Credit Corporation. You get Tercel quality and value with the security of four-wheel drive and the safety of a...
All alone again, two straight from three-point range.
John M. Crowley Field on the campus of Loyola College, and the Greyhounds feeling real good early on in this one, and also very good about their men's Division I basketball team on their first year. College flying high under their third year athletic director, Joe Boylan.
Ryan back though with that last goal on a nice right-handed drive from that unassisted. Loyola up 1-0, and we talked to Coach Kyle earlier. He said the first quarter is key. Here's the goal again. Back though, excellent size and speed. Stands a little advantage here against the Carolina defender. And he keeps six side high past the Andrea for the Loyola goal.
That was John Spears defending the junior out of Fayetteville, New York.
Here's an excellent save by McGee. Six side low bounce shot. The rebound now pops off to his right and makes the second save also. And Carolina is in the crease on that play. So McGee making two fine saves.
Well, McGee, an honorable mention, All American in his freshman season. Gave that storm in 1994, and there's a shot and a save is made, and that time Rocco D'Andrea comes up in a lined effort, and now the attempt is here by North Carolina. Sean Heffern is number three, the leading scorer. This will be a delayed call coming up against Loyola. So Carolina will maintain possession until they lose it, which they do, and now they'll go on the extra man.
going to be a holding violation against Loyola. 30-second violation.
Warrior side paying them handle. The choice of champions. Order now at 1-800-968-7845. So now North Carolina is doing an early territorial advantage. They're trailing 1-0. Brian Baxo with the only goal thus far in this one. Here's Langhoff. Good shifting defense. And Eric Reed. That was intended for Jason Wade, a sophomore from Davidsonville, Maryland. Now Loyola with the lead against the Carolina Rise.
Loyola's still down a man, so it's going to be difficult for them to clear the ball here.
This is Bowie for Loyola. For Kevin Lutz out of Boyd Latin. So that's one pass clear. And here's Uno coming in. His shot, and it's in a mass of bodies. As you know, the Uno's got a lot of quickness and some good defense on the part of North Carolina.
It's going to be a loose ball push against North Carolina. Loyola's going to maintain the ball. Look for Loyola to work the ball around. A lot of patience. And they'll try to get the matchup that they think is most advantageous. Here's the push. There's Udo. Reaching for that left-handed. And that hit was from behind. That's why it was a loose ball push.
So now Loyola leading in this one 1-0. An opportunity to expand it. North Carolina has never lost 2 in a row under head coach Dave Swanen. Last week they lost their season opener at the Carrier Dome in Syracuse. They fell by 1-0 going into the final 15 minutes before losing 17-0. Got a score! What a play! McLean Udo, a senior out of Jamaica and Springfield Gardens, New York High School. And it nets Loyola their second goal in this one.
Big goal by Loyola. McLean Udo. Right in front of the cage there, putting Loyola up 2-0. Carolina's confidence has got to be questioned. They lost last week. Here's the goal now. You'll see Udo just going to that for himself behind the cage. Elevates and puts it over the shoulder of the end. Excellent athletic play there. A lot of quickness and speed. Here it is again from the other angle. You see he put the ball in his left hand, jumps and puts it over DeAndrea. Excellent maneuver there.
So the transfer from Rutgers, Rocco DeAndrea, did not start last week against Syracuse. It was Lehrman in the net, the senior. Dave Quadman changes to a new netminder. North Carolina's down now by the score of 2-0. As we mentioned, the Tar Heels are starting in two with 10 starters. Effort and look to take the lead pass. And now North Carolina going on the attack. This is Greg Carroll, a freshman out of Harbor Field in Green Lawn, New York. Number two midfielder out there for North Carolina. This is O'Brien out of West Springfield. A lot of size for this Carolina team. Good defensive work by Jason Foley. Foley number 33 as he picks up the loose ball. Loyola wants to run. Paxo, who had the first goal, and he fires it, and it's blocked by the outer defense. As you notice, the defense converges around the netminder. And now right back from Carolina in transition. Scoreless thus far are the Tar Heels out of the Atlantic Coast Conference. But here's a shot of the score. North Carolina gets on the board as Greg Carroll drills it from head on, and it's now 2-1, 8:16 left. The first quarter from John M. Crowley Jr. Field on the campus of Loyola College.
Introducing the ultimate pepperoni pizza, new from Pizza Hut.
What are you shimmy there?
What? That's the earth. Sticky pepperoni for a whole new taste.
The ultimate. Meet us now and it could ruin everything else. I could go out with a supermodel. I'm going to go for dinner. Susan Myers would be up with me. But no, supermodel. One bite. There's no going back. You gonna eat it? Yeah.
Try one for $8.99. A second medium for $5 more.
They're always working on something new.
That's why everyone who's serious about lacrosse plays with stick equipment.
My mother uses a stick.
With stick, you'll score more goals.
Probably 1,000. 100,000 million.
The people at Stitch know the sport.
They're lacrosse players. Lacrosse players? I think my brother Paul was at Stitch. Every goal he scores at Stitch.
There they do.
Can't say any more about it.
8:16 left in this first quarter. Howard Knight along with Twin Chesnell. Kyle Durkee, a junior out of Munkin Bell and St. Paul's School, cuts the Loyola lead in half with a fine drive to put the bounce beyond McGinnis.
Nice shot by Durkee. You can see on that last play his key. There's Coach Farman now talking to Ryan Wade. Farman's done a great job at Carolina. First year there, took him to the national title. Last year they lost a heartbreaker to Syracuse in the national championship. Farman known for his discipline and well-schooled fundamentals. Really exercising the fundamentals.
Well, back in 1991, Farman became only the second rookie head coach in NCAA lacrosse history to lead his team to an undefeated season and an NCAA championship. And this is the fourth year at the helm for Dave Farman as North Carolina wins the faceoff. Jason Sanders, a sophomore from Stony Brook, New York, as North Carolina looks to get the equalizer. This is Langhoff. And he is in center behind the net. And with Mark Phillips, sophomore from Smith Sound. Battle is back. And he's got him to score. North Carolina right back down and knocks it as Merrill Turnbull, freshman from Hoback, New York, nets the goal for the Tar Heels.
Let's watch this last play. Here's a feed out front. Turnbull will catch the right hand and just fire a bounce. Kind of using the defenseman there as a screen. And McGinnis unable to make the save. Turnbull only a freshman. His father is the head coach at Yorktown Heights, or the past head coach. Actually, he retired last year. Yorktown Heights producing many players in this game, including Rocco D'Andrea, Matt Juan, and Usman Green.
So the first goal of Turnbull's career here in North Carolina was a big one, as it knocks the count at two. And we've got a stop.
It's going to be Loyola ball. Loose ball interference against Carolina.
Loyola victorious, 34 out of 39 games played here. Under their 11th year head coach, Dave Cottle.
Actually, we'll have simultaneous fouls here. We're going to have a reset.
So Loyola opening up a two-goal advantage, but the visitors out of the Atlantic Coast Conference, knotting things up very quickly. Brian Duffy, West Genesee, picks up the ball. And now Loyola trying to regain the lead before a capacity crowd here at John M. Curley Field and the campus of Loyola College. That's Derek Rattleball out of Boys Latin in Towson, Maryland. At number three, you're watching right now. He's the leading scorer, Sean Heffernan, a transfer from the Essex Community College. So Brian, with quick passing and a shot is wide. As you notice, they're trying to quick stick it in off of the left and right side of the North Carolina netminder.
That was Kevin Lutz, left-hander, very strong attacker, likes to bowl in, and he's got a cannon. He's got a very quick release, as we can see it. And assistant coach Dave Petromala for Loyola.
Sponsoring tonight's game is FTX. Now on and off the playing field, the name of the game is FTX. Exciting clothes for lacrosse players and fans. We're the real thing, FTX. That was Kevin Lutz, the junior. Another shot, it's been harder than turf. Once again was Lutz as he's winding it up from in close. Getting a high percentage shot as you watch Loyola working it in from the 5 yards off the left to right side. Amelia, the goaltender.
Excellent hustle by Kevin Lutz behind the net there, taking the ball away from the Carolina defenseman and preserving possession for Loyola.
Rocco D'Andrea, the junior transfer from Rutgers, a surprise starter in the net for Dave Quarman's Tar Heels. Brian Duffy, the sophomore number two for Loyola, had his shot blocked, and it's going to turn back now to the Tar Heels.
D'Andrea looked shaky early on, like the first two shots, but made about four or five saves in a row there and ran that shot out. So he's got his feet under him now.
Break down, Durock. So now North Carolina working a shy of midfield as Rob
Tobin, a sophomore from Annapolis. And he lets fly McGeady with another fine save. Looks very quick today in the net for Loyola.
McGeady had some injury problems early on, but he's healthy now. He looks like he's in excellent shape, actually. His quick speed looks like it's improved.
He was an honorable mention All-American in his freshman year. And looking to regain that form in his junior year. Ryan Wade, number 19, the leading scorer, part of the brother tandem, along with Jason Wade, number 43. He's Langhoff. Rob Tobin, a sophomore from Annapolis. Working against number 2, Duffy. Weather-wise, the last time we were here was Syracuse played against Loyola. Carolina looking to gain the lead, and McGeady makes the save. Tar Heels have never led in this one, but have overcome an early 2-0 deficit.
That's going to be a slashing violation against Loyola. That's their third penalty already of the game, and if they continue to foul like this, they're going to make it real tough for their goalie, Tim McGeady. Watch this save. This is a lot of quickness by McGeady. See how quick he moved that stick. Beautiful job.
So Tim McGeady, a junior, 6 feet tall, 165, out of North County High School in nearby Linthicum, Maryland. And now North Carolina with the extra man. Guzman Green, number 26, making an appearance out of the midfield, along with Jude Collins. Loyola looking to pick up the loose ball as it's knocked out of bounds. North Carolina will retain possession. 4:50 in this first quarter. We're deadlocked at 2 apiece. First game of a big doubleheader here at John M. Curley Field. It'll be Brown versus Duke in the second game. Give and go feed to McGeady with a save. And on the attempted clear, we have a whistle.
Going to be a pushing violation against Loyola. That was an incredible save by McGeady, jumping up in the air and kicking his left foot out. McGeady's hot right now. Watch this save. This is great. Got it right in the left shin.
Loyola 2-0 early on in this season, having defeated Fairfield and Adelphi. North Carolina lost their season opener to Syracuse. Syracuse awarded with a trip down to Florida to play Yale. They had a week in the sun. Sloppy passing by North Carolina. Now Loyola picking up the loose ball. Jason Foley, Jr., 6 feet tall, 185, as the Greyhounds go on the attack. And a score! A long-range outside shot taken by Mark O'Brien. A sophomore, 6'1", 175 from Springfield, Virginia, and the Greyhounds go right back on top at 3-2.
Take a look at it. Here's O'Brien coming in right-handed from about 15 yards. That's one that DeAndrea probably should have had from 15 yards. Nice shot, though, offside bounce shot. Here's O'Brien. Just steps into it. You can see his form there using his whole body behind that shot.
Well, that's the fifth goal scored by O'Brien to go along with one assist. And that long-range shot, short hop, Rocco DeAndrea. As Loyola regains the lead after two straight goals by North Carolina, brought the Atlantic Coast Conference Tar Heels even. Jason Sanders, a sophomore, blocked by the outer defense. Ground ball so important for possession in this game. To Loyola College.
Excellent hustle by Loyola on that last play. Zach Thornton, number 24, making the check.
I want to thank the sports information director, Steve Jones, for doing such a fine job, as he always does. Jones has been the SID for the last 7 years here at Loyola. And, of course, he's looking forward to the NCAA Division I basketball, men and women, from Loyola College. Moved on to the tournament play.
A little sloppy passing there by Loyola, typical of an early season game. Takes a while for these athletes to get the stick work in gear.
Kyle Darby, who scored a goal, number 21 for North Carolina. Met defensively, Brendan Fry out of Georgetown Prep in Potomac, Maryland. Durfee's got a lot of speed. Fry appears to have more size. He's had a wraparound, as you notice. Knocked it free as North Carolina. Looking to knock the count with 3:14 left in this first quarter. Dennis Plumman has a pair of attacking stations behind, and now working his way out on top, a shot, and just making the save was McKinney. You can see the quickness McKinney has as he flashed between the pipes.
McKinney's a great athlete. His lateral movement is very much like Scott Bacciolupo, who we saw last week. He just moves between the pipes very well.
Seems like Loyola.
Here it is. Take a look at the save. Moving his body. The cross goal is 6 feet wide, and it takes a lot of footwork to get from side to side.
This is Turnbull, who has a goal for Klarman's Tar Heels. Ryan Wade, as he fires it forward, and a score for North Carolina. The Tar Heels' leading scorer produces again, and we are deadlocked at 3 apiece with 2:41 left in the first quarter.
This is quintessential Ryan Wade. He loves that left hand, and watch where this shot ends up. Right in the corner, the jump shot. We saw him do that 5 times last year against Hopkins. And that's why he's a member of the United States World Team. Beautiful shot right in the corner. Very tough for the goalie to pick that up because he shoots overhand. He has the option to shoot that high or low. Still tough.
So Ryan Wade, who was the most valuable player in the Hopkins North Carolina game last season, seems to like to play against Maryland team. And now North Carolina looking to gain the lead for the first time in this one. John Spears, the junior, rifled it. Certainly not shy about winding it up from long range of the Tar Heels. Loyola likes to work it in a little closer to the 3 to 5 yard area. The North Carolina will let fly coming off the bench.
Both these teams have excellent balance. They really don't have any stars offensively, so everyone's got the green light to go to the net.
Greg Langhoff, senior Timonium. Billy Wilson, a senior for Loyola, number 34 on defense. It is a veteran defense for Loyola going against a young North Carolina attack. As we mentioned, only 2 of 10 starters from last year's team returning for North Carolina. And McGinney goes to his knees to make the save, as you noticed, on Turnbull, a freshman, looking for his second career goal. Hugh Collins, a shot and a score. North Carolina's Hugh Collins. That's another long-range bomb, and it's now 4-3. North Carolina leading in this one.
Anytime you give a shooter of Collins' ability, time and room, he's going to stick it. Look at him. He just steps into it and lets it fly from about 10 yards, beating McGinney to the stick side. He's got to step in front of these guys. You got to check them as they shoot. He had too much time and room there.
So North Carolina opening it up offensively, gaining the lead for the first time in this one. And the Tar Heels pick up the loose ball. The person of Steve Shriver, junior, out of New York. And now North Carolina looking to open it up with a bouncing shot to take that aspirin for a pop. The field is hard, and you notice on that shot, Allen went over the crossbar. And right now, there's a timeout on the field. Head coach Dave Cottle, after seeing his team open up a 2-goal advantage, falling behind for the first time with 1:24 left in the first quarter by the score of 4-3. And you see a little bit of momentum change, and we'll be back to Baltimore, Maryland, and the Evergreen campus.
Gonna get in the game. Get in the game. Blackswell, now open in and out.
Gentlemen, your opponent was hot and cold this half, but that was just an appetizer. The next half is for the whole enchilada. I'll stake my reputation on it. You need to cut them up and eat them alive. Committee, you should be licking your chops. You're bigger than these shrimps. The attack has got to be the middie.
Defense,
poke them in the ribs. Carve them up like a piece of meat. They're chickens. Okay, here they come. Pass it around. That's the way to go. Come on, guys. Now you're doing a great job. Cut it up. Slice it up. Eat them up.
We love lacrosse!
Because Lacrosse Magazine is a source for men's and women's lacrosse.
Because I still love the game so much.
Because every coach should be a member.
They make things happen.
This is awesome, man. Look at that check.
I was at that game.
Where was it?
The magazine's cool.
Howard Nash along with Quinn Kesenick here in Baltimore, Maryland. John M. Curley Field, the campus of Loyola College, where the Atlantic Coast Conference Tar Heels of North Carolina earning a 4-3 lead after falling behind 2-0 to the Greyhounds under their 11th year head coach, Dave Cottle. This is Jason Way, the brother of Ryan, number 19. Loose ball is picked up, as you notice, an opportunity as Turnbull, pesky freshman out there, just off to the left and right side of the Loyola goaltender. Certainly somebody to keep an eye on. And now North Carolina's on the attack is Greg Langhoff, the senior, met by Billy Wilson. Good D on the part of Loyola.
Excellent wrap check there by Wilson.
34 out of the last 39 games played here at John M. Curley Field have gone by way of Loyola, including the upset of the champion team of last year, Syracuse. Fast break opportunity for Loyola. And as you notice, North Carolina very quick to defense. Zach Thornton out of Edgewood, Maryland. Now we've got a flag on the play.
Flag's going to go against North Carolina. Not sure what it is. Here's the defense. Watch this wrap check right there. Just lodging the ball. Excellent defense by Wilson. That's the type of check where you let your butt end wrap around the player. Straight angle.
Tar Heels looking for their 15th straight trip to the NCAA tournament. Talk about consistency in Division I lacrosse. Willie Scrides, and then, of course, Dave Klarman in his fourth season as a rookie coach back in 1991. He led his team not only to an undefeated season to the NCAA championship, and then they lost to Princeton, Franklin Field, and, of course, they defeated Towson State a couple years ago at the Carrier Dome to win a championship, and now Loyola down by a goal. Dave Cottle said he'd like to have a double digit, a low scoring game, and that's the name of the game as defense is what Cottle looks for, the young attack out there. And that's it, the end of the first quarter with a score of the North Carolina Tar Heels 4, the Loyola Greyhounds 3.
Been a benchmark of quality for 25 years.
Just simply the best!
Toyota Corolla, ranked among the top 10 models in initial quality by J.D. Power & Associates. And available now through a special new plan from Toyota Motor Credit Corporation. With a small down payment and just $159 a month, you can lease the best Corolla ever with driver and passenger side airbags.
standard. If you want a deal, Toyota has a great deal. The Toyota Touch Plan. See your Toyota dealer today.
1994 World Championship. Division I and Division III National Championships. What do they all have in common? Warrior titanium handles. The Warrior titanium handle dominates the field of champions when compared to aluminum. Titanium offers the best strength-to-weight ratio and has no substitute for quality and performance. If you're ready to take your game to the next level, demand the original titanium handle. Demand Warrior titanium handle. Call 1-800-968-7845.
Classic television.
Hogan's Hero.
Green Acres.
Arnold Zip. Who played him?
Nobody. He was the pig.
Remember Family Affair?
Mr. French. I loved him.
Really?
He was attractive.
Pete, Link, Jules. Okay, Ginger or Marianne?
Ginger was a bimbo.
Marianne
or Jeannie?
Beechwood Age Budweiser.
Jeannie?
Howard Mash along with Quinn Kessenick back here at Curly Field on the campus of Loyola College, where North Carolina out of the Atlantic Coast Conference leads Loyola by the score of 4-3. Two quick goals by Loyola got them early on the board, but North Carolina came back at them. And out of the faceoff now for North Carolina will be Jason Saunders, a sophomore from Stony Brook, New York, and Ward Melville. A lot of fine players hailing out of that area. And Loyola gains possession.
It's going to be an offside violation against North Carolina. Loyola will have a man up advantage now for 30. Before that faceoff, Loyola was two men up. So right now, Loyola is three men up. You'll see on the field right now, North Carolina has only three defensemen, and Loyola has six offensive players. This is a must-score situation for Loyola.
So now Loyola down by a goal, and a golden opportunity to gain the equalizer. Watch for that good, quick perimeter passing. Let's see how they zing it around. A shot, a score! Loyola coming right back at him, and the person that Del Halliday, a junior, 5'10", out of Lambrick Park, a Canadian, one of the few with Division I lacrosse, and he brings Cottle's Greyhounds even with Dave Klarman's Tar Heels at 4 apiece.
Here's the goal. Thornton with the assist. And you'll see DeAndre kind of duck on this shot, and the ball goes over his shoulder. As a goaltender, you want to focus on the ball. That's all you want to watch. Here it is again. See him duck. He doesn't really watch the ball. And Halliday takes advantage of that.
So Loyola taking advantage of the two extra man opportunity to net the equalizer. We want to welcome our many new networks in this 1994 NCAA season. New England Sports Network, along with Empire State, the New York Yankee Baseball Network. Sports South out of Atlanta, Atlanta Braves Baseball Network, and of course, Home Team Sports. And now Loyola trying to regain the lead, a lead they held at 2-0 before Carolina came back. Ball as a pair of 27 in battle. 27 for North Carolina, Steve Schreiber. Baxco, who got Loyola started with the first goal in this one. Fine move, a shot sails over the crossbar. Tremendous quickness as he moved from the left to the right stick and let fly.
Baxco, a sophomore. Loyola's got an excellent sophomore class. These are individuals who Coach Cottle's counting on this year. O'Brien, who scored earlier. Baxco. If they can step up this year, Loyola's going to have a hell of a team.
Loyola victorious the first two games against Fairfield and Adelphi. That was Chris Lutz who let fly. Syracuse beat North Carolina at the Carrier Dome last week, 17-9. Only a one-goal difference going to the final 15 minutes. Superior depth on the part of Roy Simmons Jr.'s defending national champions. The telltale factor as North Carolina with only 2 of 10 Letterman returning from the 1993 team. With a fine wraparound by Schreiber that did the damage. And now a fast break for North Carolina. J. Jason Wade. And the shot hits the side of the net. You notice the brother tandem, Ryan Wade and Jason. Jason Foley trying to clear. Notice that tough Carolina ride creating some havoc now. Loyola not able to fast break. And now an action out of midfield. I think North Carolina's defense caused Loyola to move offside.
Yeah, that was an excellent ride. Loyola forced to clear with their long sticks, and it's a lot tougher to control a long stick than it is to control a short stick.
There's Jason Wade, leading scorer. His shot is wide. As Wade seems to work his way in very close to the rival netminders.
Well, he's very quick, and he's strong, and defensively he's got an excellent reputation, so there's a tendency to back in when you're covering him.
Warrior Titanium Handles, the choice of champions. Order now at 1-800-968-7845. Jason Wade. Banning on the shot for North Carolina. Rob Tobin and now Loyola. Here's Faxo, it comes in, and we got a call, although the ball was put in the net. The whistle stopped play with 12:06 left in this second quarter, the first of two to be played here at John M. Curley Field. Brown out of the Ivy League goes at it against Duke University from the Atlantic Coast Conference.
Here's a personal foul on the last play. You'll see Radova dive across the crease, and he slashed in the head right there. The whistle blew. That goal did not count. Loyola will have a man-up opportunity now for 60 seconds.
Rocco D'Andrea, the junior, a transfer from Rutgers, manning the fight for Quarmans Tar Heels. Gary Lehrman started last week against Syracuse. Now let's watch Loyola as they throw it around, looking for the open man. Heffernan out on top. You've got to watch number three. He'll either set it up or try to move in from the left or right side. Number three is the leading scorer, Heffernan, out of Essex Community College. Zach Thornton. Good quick pass and give and go. Shot and a score. What a play. The give and go feed. And Derek Radovall for Boys Latin in Towson, Maryland gives Loyola a 5-4 lead over North Carolina.
Talk about precision passing. This play, Loyola worked the ball around patiently. And now you'll see Radovall cutting to the net, catching the perfect pass and beating D'Andrea. That is a scripted play that Loyola's practiced all week, and it worked. There's our hero, Derek Radovall. Very smart player, and he's excellent off the ball. That's without the ball. He moves well in traffic and can find the open space.
So Radovall with his fourth goal of the season, and Loyola with the last two goals in this one, overcoming a 4-3 deficit, turning it into a 5-4 advantage. Fine work off the faceoff by Baxo out of Farmingdale, New York. And now Loyola looking to make it three unanswered goals in a row. This is Lutz out of Boys Latin in Jarrettsville, Maryland. Loyola, winners of 34 out of 39, played here at John M. Curley. This is O'Brien, who has scored a goal in this one. Hugh Collins faces in defensively, number 42.
Loyola now inverting offensively. Their attack players are in front of the cage, and their midfielders are behind the net.
Ryan Duffy, West Genesee, and Camellias, New York. 44 is Spears for North Carolina. Looking for somebody slanting in, but they have the middle well played. 10-19 in this second quarter. Now they're clear of the side. For O'Brien.
See the patience by this Loyola offense. They want to keep the Carolina midfielders on the field playing defense.
John Spears, the junior from Fayetteville, New York. Number 44, and there's Heffernan, number 3, the leading scorer for Cottles Greyhounds. Duffy, as he looks for somebody slanting in. Not the most patient I've seen a Loyola team. Of course, Kevin Beach, who was a star last year, graduated. And he used to get the ball to Beach and clear the side for a change. And a good wraparound by North Carolina defensively. That was Drew Collins. So Collins not only playing the big-time offense, but the defense nets Carolina the ball. Side against North Carolina, and Loyola will go on the attack once again.
Nice check by Billy Wilson, the senior defenseman for Loyola. He's such a consistent player. Nothing flashy, but he's out there every week playing as hard as he can, getting the most out of his potential.
Next week's Lacrosse 94 Game of the Week will feature Johns Hopkins University against the defending NCAA Division I champions, the Syracuse Orangemen, under Roy Simmons Jr. Halliday picks up the loose ball. Nifty over the head feed. But it's going to go back to the Tar Heels.
That's a 10-second violation. When the ball leaves the offensive box, you've got 10 seconds to bring it back in. And that time, Halliday did not get the ball back into the box. He made a great athletic play there, flipping the ball over his head.
Loyola, 6 consecutive playoff appearances. 15 straight times, North Carolina has made it to the tournament. And now North Carolina falling behind for the second time in this one after regaining a 4-3 lead. Spencer Deering, a freshman out of Baltimore, number 7.
And that's a freshman mistake right there. Loyola controlled the ball for nearly 2 minutes. Carolina got the ball down on offense. You have to work the ball around for a good shot. That time Deering turned the ball over very quickly.
Well, we 19-34 Letterman off of last year's team have returned for head coach Dave Foreman, who in his rookie season took North Carolina to a perfect record in the NCAA championship. And of course, Dave Cottle really has revitalized this program. And a save made by McGeaney.
Nice save by McGeaney there.
Fast break for Loyola, and a shot. A fight shot. And it's going to still belong to the Greyhounds. About as quick a Loyola team as I've seen in the last couple of years.
They've got balance this year. Last year, their offense was geared towards Canabine and Beach. And this year, it's spread around.
Here's Heffernan, leading goal producer this season, transfer out of Essex Community College. Give it up for Lutz, Kevin Lutz. He looks to back dodge in. Trying to keep it in bounds for Loyola was Derek Redabaugh, who netted a goal in this one. Out of Boys Latin in Towson, Maryland. And North Carolina now will go the length of the field. Ryan Wade. 7:37 left in the second quarter. Howard Nash along with Quint Kesenick. You're watching Lacrosse 94, the first of two today. In the second game, it'll be Brown out of the Ivy League against Duke University. Now, this is the number 2 and 7th ranked teams in the country. If you believe these early polls, the first couple weeks of the season. But perennially, these two teams have made it to the playoff. That's going to be a turnover, giving the ball back to Loyola.
Interference call against Carolina. Loyola set to clear. Preseason rankings are just that, preseason rankings. And I think Carolina's number 2 ranking is indicative of their season last year and not the team they're fielding this season.
As Udo will have it, now forced to settle things down. Sean Heffernan, 5'6". Reminds you of Todd Cavallaro of the Johns Hopkins Blue Jays with his quickness and speed. Ryan Kelly, another player of the same size.
A score for Loyola. What a play. And Derek Radabaugh moves Loyola to a 6-4 lead in this one.
It's time to get the best for your money. Now, Toyota Motor Credit offers a special new lease on the best car built in America, Toyota Camry. With a small down payment and just $259 a month, you can drive the best American family sedan. With safety features like driver and passenger side airbags. Standard. That's Toyota Camry. If you want a deal, Toyota has a great deal. The Toyota Touch Plan. See your Toyota dealer today.
For the creators of the game, it was more than competition. It was a ritual of the spirit. For those who take the game seriously, there is only one place for sticks with custom designed and engineered pockets, protective equipment, team apparel, sportswear, custom clothing, and specialty items. Allman Sports International. Visit our extensive showroom at 7 West Aylesbury Road in Timonium. We take the game seriously.
Lacrosse Magazine is a source for men's and women's lacrosse.
Because I still love the game so much.
Because every coach should be a member.
They make things happen.
This is awesome, man. Look at that chest.
I was at their team.
Where was it?
The magazine's cool.
Yeah. Here's Derek Radabaugh's last goal. He has no fear. Watch him attack the heart of the defense here. Taking the check right there. Just taking it right down the middle of the field. Bouncing it between DeAndre's legs. Nice effort.
That was Steve Schreiber defensively, the junior out of Esau Tuck in New York and Ward Melville High School trying to defend. But Radabaugh nets his second, and Loyola equals their largest lead in this one. As that shot for Carolina was by Jude Collins, a sophomore from Alexandria, Virginia. But North Carolina will go on the attack. Territorially, it appears that Loyola really turned things around. And the Loyola defense coming to life. It's been over 8.5 minutes since North Carolina has scored after opening up that 4-3 lead. And three straight goals by Loyola unanswered have opened up two. As a shot and a score, North Carolina coming right back at them. And it's now 6-5, a good in-close shot by North Carolina as Carey nets it for the Tar Heels.
Take a look at this. Watch this behind-the-back shot now. There's the over-the-head check that's missed, and he comes in and puts it behind his back, beating McGeaney and the Loyola defenseman. Beautiful shot by Carey. This is the best shot we've seen so far. That's not good defense right there. You do not want to go over the head there. Carey putting the ball behind his back.
Kind of reminds you of Marischak when he played for Syracuse. And Zilberti back in the shades of the late 80s and early 90s when they used to put it behind her back and do the spin moves. But the name of the game is to get it in the cage, and North Carolina comes back to make it 6-5. And they win the faceoff. So momentum starting to turn now for Klarman's Tar Heels. As they continue to bomb away from long range. And Loyola looking to fast break. Zach Thornton. Perhaps a push from behind against North Carolina as the flag is thrown from off the action.
Actually, we're going to have two fouls originally on that play when Zach Thornton was running the ball up the field. He was flat, and this is going to be a push. Here's Matt Dwan, the long stick defenseman for Loyola, being pushed from behind. Excellent call. You can see the contact was made in Dwan's back. So it's going to be two men down now for North Carolina.
You mentioned Matt Dwan, of course, his brother Billy Dwan sparkled defensively for many years for Johns Hopkins University, carrying on that fine tradition in the Dwan family. And with the score, 6-5 Loyola. We'll be back.
Introducing the ultimate pepperoni pizza. New from Pizza Hut.
Maybe we shouldn't eat this. What?
Zesty herbs, thicker pepperoni for a whole new taste.
It's the ultimate. We eat this now and it could ruin everything else. It's like you go out with a supermodel. So many girls would be nothing. Susan Myers would be okay. But no supermodel. One bite. There's no going back. So you gonna eat it?
Yeah.
Try one for $8.99. Second medium for $5 more. If you're gonna get in the game, get in the game. Blackswell, now open in Annapolis.
Classic television. Hogan's Heroes.
Green Acres.
Arnold Zip. Who played him?
Nobody. He was the pig.
Remember Family Affair?
Mr. French. I loved him.
Maybe.
Maybe Tractor.
Pete, Link, Julie. Okay, Ginger or Marianne?
Ginger was a bimbo.
Marianne.
Or Jeannie.
Beechwood Age Budweiser.
Jeannie.
Crisp, clean, classic.
Howard Mash along with Quinn Kasadek welcoming you back to John M. Curley Jr. Field. The first of two, a big doubleheader played today. It'll be Brown and Duke in the second game. 6-5 lead for Loyola. They've had two goals scored with a pair of extra men. And North Carolina has scored one goal with the extra man, and that's the difference in this one as you watch that quick perimeter passing. Save off of the left leg. Loyola territorially dominating play at this stage, nursing a one goal advantage with the extra man. This is Halliday. And North Carolina will have possession.
That was DeAndrea's best save. Nice kick save. We saw McGinney do that earlier.
So the key to this one, North Carolina 0-3 with the extra man, and Loyola 2-4. But it's North Carolina fast breaking, trying to get the equalizer as McGinney sparkling in this first half of action. Appears to be regaining his honorable mention form of his freshman season 2 years ago. Now we got a timeout being called right now by Dave Cottle and the Loyola College Greyhounds. Cottle, in his 11th year at the helm, brought his team to the 1990 championship against Syracuse. Actually led in that game 3-2 early.
Here's the shot. Here's the save. There's Radabaugh catching the ball inside for a jump shot. And you can see DeAndrea just getting his right foot kick save. Bacigalupo did that last week against Hopkins a couple times. Watch this check. Watch this aggressive play. Lacrosse is a physical sport, and there's Kane taking the ball away from the Carolina defender.
I'll tell you, whenever you play North Carolina, you know, under Dave Farman, you're going to have an intense game. Alex Martin played that way last year. Of course, he graduated. And that's been the keynote of North Carolina's success through the years, as well as Duke this year and last year under Mike Kressler, the head coach of Duke. And we'll be seeing the Blue Devils going at it against Brown in game number two.
Athletically, generally, North Carolina and Syracuse are the two most physical teams in the country. And after a game against those two teams, you walk off the field knowing that you've played 60 minutes. Bruises, cuts. It's just a tough experience.
Talk about a lot of physical play. We do reflect back on that 1990 final as we take a look at some shots on goal. North Carolina with 21 and Loyola 19, kind of reflecting this one goal advantage for Loyola. Either team is led by more than two, and Loyola has done it on two separate occasions as Sean Heffernan initiates the attack for the Greyhounds. Now a pair of attackmen behind the net for Loyola. Both teams going to find fine job picking up the loose balls off this AstroTurf fast break opportunity. A shot and a score! Right back at him, North Carolina. And Greg Langhoff took a head man feed and blistered it home to knock the count at six.
This is that's the type of goal that Loyola does not want to give up this afternoon. That's a patented North Carolina fast break. Brendan Carey feeding Langhoff for the shot to the off-stick side. McGinney had no chance on that one. Loyola wants a slow-tempo game. This is exactly the type of game that Carolina wants, that up-tempo transition style. Here's the defense. You'll see Heffernan slip there on the AstroTurf. Occasionally, the AstroTurf, if you cut with the grain, they'll slip. And that's where it started, DeAndrea throwing the excellent outlet pass.
So DeAndrea making a fine clearing feed, and Langhoff did the rest. You know, we talk about Dave Cottle. He wanted a score in single digits, and that's just what he wanted to avoid. The scores in rapid-fire fashion, and North Carolina has done just that to knock the proceedings at six apiece.
Oh, what a shot, a score! Flying in from behind, and North Carolina,
it appears they scored it, but now they say that in the crease was the flying Brendan Carey. And we'll take a look at that one, the sophomore from Huntington, New York.
Take a look at this. The officials are still talking about it. Backhanded pass McGinney.
Kind of reminded you of the gate flying through the carrier dome.
This is a real common move now on lacrosse. There's a slash in the back of the head. No foul was thrown. But here he is, inside roll. Watch him just head straight towards the net and dive. He doesn't step in the crease there. Beautiful shot. No goal, though.
So the officials with the best view in the house, matter of inches. And North Carolina remains deadlocked with Loyola at 6 apiece.
Referees are still discussing this call. It looks like Carolina is going to maintain control with a man advantage because they only see five defensemen for Loyola.
As they still discuss all the action,
you can see the Loyola coaching staff, Dave Cottle, and there's Quarman and his assistant Robbie Russell behind him in the gray sweatshirt.
Career record of 42-6 for Dave Quarman. Back in 1991, his rookie season, he led the Atlantic Coast Conference Tar Heels to the NCAA championship as that team went undefeated. And now North Carolina back on the attack. Collins for Ryan Wade. For Langhoff, back to Wade. Watch the defenseman as they form a box around the net line of McGinney. So they want to keep North Carolina away from the front of the net. Collins is the middleman out on top. Brothers Wade off to the lower part of your screen. And this is Ryan. Collins from Alexander, Virginia. Clearing the side. Loyola playing fine defense. That's Brendan Fly out of St. Mary's in Annapolis. Goes across the end line. So credit Loyola. So tenacious defense, netting them possession as we remain tied at six apiece.
Brendan Fry, excellent defense. He's another sophomore in this Loyola team. They have one of the best sophomore classes in the entire country.
Von Udo tries to weave as he stick checks. Looks like North Carolina is stepping it up a notch here as they have deadlocked this one with 1:58 left. And a fine save, McGinney. One of his knees to make a fine play on that one.
That's the running gun style that Loyola does not want and Carolina does. And as this game goes on and the players get tired, I think we'll be seeing more of that transition style. It definitely favors North Carolina.
They didn't carry the sophomore, number 9. Back left. player who came in from the left side and was called for being in the crease, and they fired in the goal. And as Loyola gains possession, once again, we're going to see a flag and a call coming up against the Greyhounds.
Here's the call. This is going to be... this is going to be a loose ball push here, but on the right there, they're also getting Fry actually for a slash. You can see the Loyola defenseman pounding on Carey on his back. You must get contact with the stick. And watch here, you'll see Jason Foley just wind up and slash the elbow again and again and again. That's a slash. Good call by the official.
Loyola's biggest lead has been two goals. North Carolina, the last time they led, was by one at 4-3. Three straight by Loyola, and now a pair for North Carolina. So momentum shifting back and forth in this one. Two heavyweights in the NCAA Division I rankings. Number two, North Carolina, 0-1, losers to the defending national champion Orangemen out of Syracuse last week at the Carrier Dome. 2-0 for Loyola. Victors over Fairfield and Adelphi. Guzman Green, number 26. Ryan Wade.
Great hustle by McGeaney there. When the ball goes out of bounds on a shot, it's the player who's closest to the ball when it crosses the line. And that time, McGeaney darted out of the net, and he was the closest. It helps if you're an athletic goaltender. You can pick up a few possessions over the course of a game.
Tim McGeaney, Jr., 6 feet tall, 165 from North County, and Olympic of Maryland, certainly appears to be regaining his freshman form, where he was honorable mention All-American. 53 seconds left in this second period. 6-6 from John M. Curley Field.
Take a look at this. Here the Loyola player steps on the line. That was almost a push from behind. That's what the coaching staff for Loyola was looking for. This game is definitely picked up as far as physical contact.
That was Pete Murphy, number 13, a freshman out of Garden City, New York, introducing himself to one of the Loyola players. Now with the clock winding down, North Carolina. See if they sit on the ball for the last 37 seconds until halftime. This is Turnbull. The freshman who has scored in this one, Turnbull. Good D on the part of Loyola's Brendan Fry. And it nets the Greyhounds possession with 20 seconds to go in this second quarter.
You can see the Carolina player calling with a push. He was actually pushed. Excellent hustle by Loyola. They're just all over the ground balls. There's no way that Carolina player was going to be able to scoop that ball. He had four white jerseys surrounding him.
20 seconds left until halftime. We're deadlocked at 6 apiece as Loyola will have possession and trying to gain a psychological edge as well as an edge on the scoreboard. They're able to score right now. This is Radabaugh. Scored a goal with somebody slanting in with 8 seconds. Now 7 as he is dumped. And now as Carolina chases it down along the near sidelines, we've got one tick of the clock left. And a length of field shot is drilled, and McGeaney makes the save, and that's it. Back where we started, deadlocked in this one at Loyola College. And North Carolina doing battle here in Baltimore, Maryland.
HTS in April. For over 20 years, Baltimore's known the name Ernie Swanson. Ernie Swanson Olds is your no-hassle dealer on Crane Highway in good old Glen Burnie with four best deals. Like Ativa, just $13,995. Or Sierra, only $14,995. Or an Ernie Swanson Cutlass Supreme, $16,995. And yes, even 88 at $19,995. And remember, these Ernie Swanson Olds are equipped, not stripped, with airbag and anti-lock brakes. So find out why they say everybody rolls at Ernie Swanson Olds, Glen Burnie.
The Reds in opening exhibition action Monday night at 7 on HTS.
Hi, everybody. I'm Al Koken, inviting you to join me on the Bullets Report. A half an hour before every home game here on HTS, I'll have the Bullets Report for you. We'll update you on what's going on with the Bullets as well as the rest of the NBA. All of that from the best seat in the house. So join me for the Bullets Report on right here on HTS.
Time. North Carolina taking on Loyola College Greyhounds. A pleasure to have with us the third-year athletic director, Joe Boylan. A lot of enthusiasm, excitement here on campus. Your NCAA Division I men's and women's basketball teams have made it into the NCAAs.
Oh, it's a terrific week for Loyola College Athletics. I mean, it's last week was arguably the biggest week since the men's team went to the finals game at Rutgers in 1990 against Syracuse. So to have both our teams in the NCAA tournament is just unbelievable. So we're all living a dream. It's a miracle, and we're enjoying every minute of it.
Of course, Skip Prosser came over from Xavier. Did you have any idea, you know, that things would blossom so quickly in his first year here and the students would really take into this team?
Well, no. I mean, it's easy to say now. Skip's a special person and a special coach. This is a rare example, I think, where two coaches have made a dramatic difference in their program. I always thought the women's program would go to the NCAA first. I didn't realize it was the only 36 hours before the men's program. So it's terrific for the school.
Joe, what is the success that Dave Cottle's had here with the lacrosse team, and now, of course, with your success in Division I basketball, men's and women's? What does this do to your athletic program in terms of recruiting and letting people know about Loyola of Maryland?
Well, in a private institution today, it's important that you have a total program. I think students want to come where they have Division I athletics. Dave's done an unbelievable job with our men's lacrosse program. Obviously, one of only four teams to be in the tournament six consecutive years, and he's really set the standard that Skip and Patty have tried to reach. And the other thing, Howard, is the way these coaches get along. Dave's spoken to both Coach Coyle's women's team and Skip Prosser's men's team, and at 12 o'clock today, Dave Cottle has asked Skip to talk to his team. So it's a unique relationship where the coaches really like each other. And then you put Diane Aiken in, one of the premier women coaches in the country. You have a staff that's terrific. And I just sit back and enjoy it and have a good time.
There's been some speculation that perhaps Loyola College may look into the Atlantic 10 in basketball. You care to comment about that?
Well, I think it's very premature now. We've had one good year. I think people get all excited. But as in everything in life, you never say never. And obviously the school, I think, took a position, Father Selinger and Tom Shy and the administration about 10 years ago to move the school from a commuter school to a regional university. And regional, it's one of the best in the Northeast. But it's really premature now. We're very happy in the MAC, and obviously we're going to tournaments, so life is wonderful here.
Dave Cottle, of course, took his team to the finals against Syracuse. What are your recollections back there? You were at Rutgers during that time.
Well, my biggest recollection is being on the field during the Yale game when they were down, and it was raining, as you well recall. It was a miserable day, and I started to walk away, and Loyola scored. I said, well, maybe I'll stay and watch it. And as you remember, it was an incredible comeback. So I remember very well the enthusiasm that Father Selinger had and the administration. And I said, gee, this is a neat place for college athletics. And the other thing is, I think, as most schools do, Loyola does it right. We graduate our students. Last year, our record on a five-year rolling basis was the seventh in the country for graduation rate. So not only our students graduate, but they're also successful. You just have to look around Baltimore and Maryland and see that. So, and that's what it's all about 10 years down the road. What did your players do? You want to get into tournaments and you want to be successful, but they have to contribute to society. Here at Loyola, they're contributing to society, so we're really happy about that.
Very popular and successful third-year athletic director here at Loyola College. Best of luck today, as well as in the NCAAs, both men and women.
Thanks, Howard. It should be fun.
It should be terrific, and we'll be back with more statistics here at halftime here at Curly Field, beautiful Evergreen campus. Loyola College, the scene of all the action in Baltimore, Maryland, and we'll be back.
That's right. When it comes to Dodge cars,
Dodge trucks,
smart buyers who simply refuse to pay too much, come to Tate Dodge of Glen Burnie.
Tate is Baltimore's number one store for minivans.
Look at this Caravan at the famous Tate discount price.
This Dodge Dakota with AC.
This Dodge Intrepid.
And now say hello to the all-new Dodge Neon.
For cars.
For trucks.
For laughs.
See Tate Dodge of Glen Burnie,
Baltimore's number one Dodge dealer.
Nobody has what Tate has.
Why do hundreds of people a day turn to alternative health care at Yalich Clinics? Because it works.
I developed severe neck and back pain from a lot of driving, and after treatment, I'm now driving pain-free.
Well, because of my low back pain, I wasn't able to work out like I'd like to. But since I've come to Yalich, I've been able to work out three times a week.
I was in a very bad car accident. I was in a lot of pain. Started treatment with Yalich Clinic, and I feel great.
Yalich Clinic, your alternative, because it works.
This is Total Playoff Drive Crunch Time. It's do or die for the Caps. All April 1 on HTS. The ultimate sports event, seen by more fans than the Super Bowl, World Series, Stanley Cup, and the NBA Finals combined. The World Cup, played on U.S. soil for the first time ever. Now, find out everything you need to know and more with Soccer 94, the favorites, the dark horses, and follow the progress of the upstart U.S. World Team. When it comes to the World Cup, you'll know the score with Soccer 94, only on HTS.
It's time for friends to fly free on Southwest Airlines.
Wake up and smell the coffee.
And people are friendlier than ever. Just make reservations at least a day in advance and buy your round-trip ticket at Southwest's regular low unrestricted fare, and a friend flies with you, free, anywhere we fly.
Yo, Dad, what do you think?
Friends fly free on Southwest Airlines. It's just plain smart. Call 1-800-IFLY-FWA.
Howard Mash along with Quinn Kasenick back here at John M. Curley Jr. Field on the campus of Loyola College in Baltimore, Maryland. We're deadlocked at 6 apiece as we start the second half of action. North Carolina and Loyola. Loyola is led by as many as 2. North Carolina's biggest lead was 1 at 4-3. And going to get back now, the North Carolina Tar Heels under fourth-year head coach Dave Klarman. Spencer Deering, number 7, behind the net. Greg Langhoff has scored a goal in the first quarter. That's Langhoff. Feed out on top, a shot on the score. North Carolina gets on the board very quickly to start this second half. Rob Tobin, a sophomore out of Annapolis, Maryland, took the feed from behind, and it's now 7-6 Tar Heels.
Early on in the game, we saw Spencer Deering force the crease, and this is an excellent feed. There's Deering, the freshman, spotting Tobin all alone in front for the easy goal. Just a nice look by Deering, field awareness. He played locally here in Baltimore for the Friends School. Look at that nice look away feed. Pass and catch lacrosse, that's an easy goal.
Tar Heels bidding to make it 15 straight trips to the NCAA tournament. Dave Klarman, 42-6 overall in his fourth season at the helm, taking over from Willie Scroggs. And now Loyola trying to get the equalizer here in the second half. Probably the quickest team to play for Dave Cottle that we've seen anyway in the last 5 years. He played very well last year against Syracuse in lacrosse 93's second game of the season. A game that Loyola won in overtime. Kevin Lutz, a shot, a score! Loyola right back at
Didn't get much playing time last year. Watch his left-handed move. He's so strong. 5'10", 200 pounds. Comes in, lowers his stick, and beats DeAndrea. And then takes the check. You've got to be tough to be a successful attacker. You cannot be afraid to stick your nose to the heart of the defense. You can see him take that hit afterwards. Nice shot by Lowe.
Marco DeAndrea, the 6-foot transfer from Rutgers, manning the plate for Klarman Tar Heels. And for Loyola, Tim McGeaney, the junior, as a freshman, an honorable mention All-American, trying to regain that form of yesteryear, and certainly sparkled in the first half of action. Six straight. Take a look now at the Pizza Hut halftime statistics. 24 shots to 19 for North Carolina. Saves Loyola 14-8. Look at the face-offs. Over 2-1 in favor of North Carolina. Ground balls even. Those extra man scoring opportunities. 3 for Loyola as North Carolina shoots and scores. They come right back again. Johnny Spears, the junior, Fayetteville, North Carolina, and James Weld, DeVitt High School. And it's now 8-7, North Carolina, both teams filling it up.
Ooh, take a look at that shake and bake move, leaving the Loyola defenseman in his tracks. Spears just steps up and fires it low. Excellent move, change of direction, faked right, faked left, and took the shot.
So 3 goals scored in a minute and 17 seconds, 2 for the Tar Heels and 1 for Loyola, and that's the difference in the game. And take a look at the scoring leaders for Loyola. Rattleball with 2. Faxo, Halliday, Udo, and O'Brien. So rather divided scoring, very balanced. And for North Carolina, extremely balanced scoring. Carey, Wade, Collins, Langhoff, and Turnbull with 1 apiece. Carey also has an assist. And here's Loyola coming back off of the faceoff. Biggest lead for North Carolina is this 1-goal advantage they currently enjoy.
That's a play-on violation. When the goalie's in the crease, they're not allowed to make contact with the stick, and that time the Loyola attacker checked Rocco DeAndrea's stick. And Coach Klarman, head coach of North Carolina, who was an assistant, actually, at Carolina for about 10 or 11 years under Willie Scroggs. And his assistants, Robbie Russell and Chip Mayer, are both Carolina graduates.
No North Carolina team has ever lost 2 in a row under Dave Foreman. And they pick up a loose ball, a shot and a score. Spencer Deering, the freshman, opportunistic out of Baltimore and Friends School, gives North Carolina the largest lead in this one at 9-7.
Spencer Deering now with an assist and a goal here in the second half. This is a garbage goal. Here's Deering's initial shot. McGeaney makes the save, and there's a rebound in front. And this is what Deering pick it up, jump up in the air, and score. Excellent garbage goal.
So that's 1 goal and 1 assist so far in 1994 for Spencer Deering. And in the face-off department, where North Carolina has enjoyed a better than 2-1 advantage over Loyola, it's the Greyhounds looking to pick it up.
That's a hole! Come on, Mark! Mark, don't try, wake up!
And again, North Carolina with a few unforced errors by the Tar Heels in this one. Sean Heffernan. I'm going to keep an eye on number 3, is yet to score. Coming into this one, the leading scorer for Loyola in 1994. He is a Delaney High School and then attended Essex Community College in Cockeysville, Maryland. Take a look at the scoring by quarters. You see how even this game is. 4-3 Carolina, then 3-2 Loyola. North Carolina opening up 3-1 as they continue offensively. Loyola looking to get back at them. They've only played 2.5 minutes in this third quarter, and I've already seen 4 goals scored. This is Derek Rattleball, who has 2 goals thus far, number 27. As DeAndrea, the young goaltender, appears to get his footing as the game progresses.
That was a nice save by DeAndrea, but Kevin Lutz blocked his view on that outlet pass. You'll see here, DeAndrea can't see around Lutz, and therefore throws a bad pass. And you can see Klarman catch the ball. Look how steady he is. Klarman's a very intense coach.
The big astroturf hop.
Warrior Titanium Handles, the choice of champions. Order now at 1-800-968-7845. Now Loyola trying to turn the momentum around in their favor. Outscored 3-1 to start the third quarter, trailing by two. This is Duffy. Brian Duffy met defensively. By the Tar Heels. Say, last week, North Carolina only trailed by one goal at the end of the third quarter against Syracuse. And in talking to some of the Syracuse players, after the game, they said that it was the depth of Syracuse that did in North Carolina. So we'll keep an eye on that as the game progresses. Not very many line changes employed by Dave Farman. Of course, the weather is cool, so that'll be a factor as well. And Carolina may be able to survive the lack of depth. What a fine wraparound by Loyola. And you got to credit Brendan Fly, a sophomore out of Georgetown Prep and nearby Potomac, Maryland, for netting Loyola possession.
I spoke to Dave Petromala, Loyola assistant defensive coach. He speaks very highly of Brendan Fry. Fry is a sophomore, played in the North-South game when he was in high school. He's a gifted athlete. He's really an unknown right now, but look for good things out of Brendan Fry.
Well, you can see the difference defensively with the leadership of a Dave Petromala has added to the coaching staff of Loyola. Fast break and opportunity now. It's something you don't want to allow North Carolina to get in the high gear, so you want to settle things down. And that's Petromala working with the defense.
Carolina now looking to isolate against the short stick.
Langhoff against Baxel. Out on top. McGeady with a save. Nifty footwork by Billy Wilson, a senior out of West Genesee. And this is Heffernan. As we mentioned, number three was the leading scorer coming into this one and has been held scoreless thus far. 9-7, North Carolina enjoying their largest lead in this one. Watch Kevin Lutz, junior out of Boys Latin, Jarrettsville, Maryland. 27, Lattaball has a pair of goals. And we've got an infraction coming up against North Carolina.
Flashing call there. You could hear it. Lattaball getting hit cleanly. Here's an excellent view of that last flash. Chuck Bresci. And now you see the Carolina slide, and Lattaball gets it right on the face mask. Watch this, a save by McGeany here. Very quick. There's a shot by Spears, and McGeany gets a foot or a stick on it.
So now Loyola, down by two. This is Heffernan to Duffy. Look at that quick perimeter passing. You watch the shifting defense. There's a shot from outside, and a save made by DeAndrea. In transition, this is Jason Sanders. For Carey out of Huntington, New York. North Carolina, a team that lost last week, has never lost two in a row under head coach Dave Klarman. Ranked number two to start the action in 1994. The defense now put to the test, and Brian Duffy comes away with it. Fast break shot. Goal! What a play as Loyola makes it a one-goal game here in Baltimore.
It's time to get the best for your money.
You're simply the best.
And now Toyota Motor Credit offers a special new lease on the best car built in America, Toyota Camry. With a small down payment and just $259 a month, you can drive the best American family sedan with safety features like driver and passenger side airbags. Standard. That's Toyota Camry. If you want a deal, Toyota has a great deal. The Toyota Touch Plan. See your Toyota dealer today.
Gentlemen, your opponent was hot and cold this half, but that was just an appetizer.
The next half is for the whole enchilada.
I'll stake my reputation on it.
You need to cut them up and eat them alive.
Mitty, you should be licking your chops. You're bigger than these shrimp. The attack has got to feed the mitty. Defense.
Poke them in the ribs. Carve them up like a piece of meat. The chicken. Okay, here they come. Pass it around. That's the way to go. Come on, guys. Now you're doing a great job. Cut it up. Slice it up. Eat them up.
It's a round world. Genuine and true. It keeps on spinning, man. You always come through. And you're giving it your best.
Proud to be your bud.
Budweiser.
Proud to be your bud. Proud to be your bud.
Ooh, yeah.
Proud to be your
bud. Proud to be your bud.
8:54 in the third quarter, and it's now a 9-8 game in favor of North Carolina. What is it that Dave Quarbin might have told his troops at halftime to get him out of the box so quickly in his third quarter?
I think Carolina just showing better intensity. Here's that last goal. Watch Heffernan and his feet. Excellent feed to Radabaugh. DeAndrea comes out of the net. Credit that goal to an excellent sliding defense by Loyola to generate the turnover, and then some nifty passing with the assist going to Heffernan. Great pass.
The Weinberchen has been praised as the area's only wine connoisseur, shelving everything from a casual Chardonnay to a particular rare vintage. Enhancing that special occasion, the Weinberchen offers an enormous selection and a knowledgeable wine staff to help find exactly what you're looking for. Take the guesswork out of wine and bar planning. Call or visit the Weinberchen located on Falls Road in Greenspring Station. Area code 410-321-6500. That's the Weinberchen, country charm with a cosmopolitan flavor. North Carolina winning another face, and McGinney anticipating. Fine anticipation. McGinney, a veteran now, overcoming a rocky year last year. Loyola trailing by one. And now in transition. And Prime shoots it four. And the Greyhounds explode and knock the count once again at 9-9.
Matt Dwan with that last goal. Watch him control this stick like it's a short stick. There's Brendan Fry with an excellent upfield pass to Dwan. And watch Ryan Wade now. He's all over Dwan, but Dwan skips the stick and fires the sidearm shot. Tremendous skill. Matt Dwan's interesting story. Was not highly recruited out of high school. And in fact, would have attended Johns Hopkins like his brother if Hopkins had shown any interest. But Hopkins didn't, and Dave Cottle spotted him.
So Matt Dwan carries on the fine family tradition. Billy Dwan, an All-American at Johns Hopkins. He played the defense. Matt Dwan playing offensively. And they've got the count now. Has the Greyhounds at 9 apiece. As that poke check delivered by Jason Foley. As he avoids the wraparound. All the way out of Yorktown Heights in New York. And now the Greyhounds. Trying to regain the lead. As we have Seesaw here at John M. Curley Field, the first game of a doubleheader featuring Brown and Duke in the second game this afternoon. This is Kevin Lutz out of Boys Latin. And Crawford shot a score! Dale Halliday from Lambert, the Canadian, as the crowd erupts, Loyola leads 10-9.
Here's the check defensively for Loyola. Foley, a nice poke check. And there's Matt Dwan. Watch his backhand flip play. Back to Foley, and Loyola's on offense. And here's the goal. Here's Heffernan feeding Holiday. The right-hander cutting towards the net. Excellent off-ball movement. When the ball's behind the net, it's extremely tough to cover the offensive player as they cut to the net.
Holiday now with two goals, as does Derek Radabaugh. And Loyola, after falling behind 9-7, which was their biggest deficit, have scored three goals in rapid-fire fashion, and with 7:07 left in the third, have moved out to a 10-9 lead.
You can see for Loyola where their offense starts with their defense. When they're playing solid defense, creating turnovers, they're an excellent team, as we've seen over the last 5 years.
Usman Green from North Carolina. He's a junior from Yorktown Heights, New York, number 26. It is a play at behind for Langhoff. A try letterman is Langhoff, one of the co-captains. And he is the feeder stationed behind the net. This is Green. And your watch are going to try to clear the side. He's going to try to full dodge around the defender. Short hop pick up by Turnbull, the freshman who scored his first career goal today. Good hustle on the part of Langhoff.
They're awarding that ball to North Carolina. I thought it was a pass inside, but they're saying that it was a shot and that Langhoff was closer. Here we get a close-up of Langhoff.
Tar Heels looking for their 15th straight trip to the NCAA tournament. Under Dave Cottle, the Greyhounds, six consecutive playoff appearances. Preseason rankings, number 2, Carolina versus number 7, Loyola. Watch the defense converge as McGinney. And a fast break. Brendan Fry, Georgetown prep. He accelerates. A wrap from behind. So the good defense slows down Loyola, albeit temporarily, as Lutz looks for a cutter. He weaves. He shoots. He scores.
Kevin Lutz did it all. And Loyola now leads in this one 11-9.
Introducing the ultimate pepperoni pizza, new from Pizza Hut.
Maybe we shouldn't eat this. What?
Zesty herbs, thicker pepperoni for a whole new taste.
It's the ultimate. We eat this now and it could ruin everything else. It's like you go out with a supermodel. Senior girls would be nothing. Susan Myers would be okay. But no supermodel. One bite. There's no going back. So you gonna eat it?
Yeah.
Try one for $8.99. Second medium for $5 more. If you're gonna get in the game, get in the game. Blackswell, now open in Annapolis.
Classic television.
Hogan's Heroes.
Green Acres.
Arnold Zipper. Who played him?
Nobody. He was the pig.
Remember Family Affair?
Mr. French.
I liked him.
Dee
Dee. He's attractive.
Pete, Link, Jules. Okay, Ginger or Marianne?
Ginger was a bimbo.
Marianne.
Marianne or Jeannie?
Beechwood Age Budweiser.
Jeannie.
Crisp, clean, classic.
Well, take a look at the score by quarters. Gives you an idea how close this game is. North Carolina 4-3 edge, and then right back Loyola. We were deadlocked at halftime at 6 apiece. And then after North Carolina scored the first two goals in the third quarter, Loyola has outscored them 5-1 and has opened up their biggest lead in this one, or equalized it, that is, at 11-9. And now out of the faceoff for North Carolina. Brendan Carey, the sophomore, Huntington, New York, Huntington High School. Zach Thornton, John Carroll, Essex Community College, out of Edgewood, Maryland. He is a junior.
Zach Thornton, a second-team All-American soccer goalie here at Loyola.
And they have a terrific program, as does the men's basketball team, making it to the NCAAs in Division I, winners of the MAC Conference. Skip Crosser, in his first year at the helm, turned around a team that was 2-22 and captured the tournament. And the women's basketball team also made it. So with enthusiasm for sports here at Loyola Maryland campus running high, as the athletic director Joe Boylan in his third year should be congratulated, along with Steve Jones, seventh year sports information director. Certainly appreciate their hospitality. Always a pleasure to visit Evergreen Campus here in Baltimore, Maryland. This is Udo. North Carolina team, coached by Dave Foreman, has never lost two games in a row. And in their season opener against Syracuse, they were upended 17-9 last week, threatening a two-game losing streak.
Coach Klarman's going to be tested this year. He's got a young squad, a lot of new faces.
Only two out of the 10 Lettermen of last year are returning on the starting team. 19 out of 34 overall, so it is a young North Carolina team. But I tell you what, with the Waves and Turnbull, the freshman, Langhoff, certainly don't lack talent. Only trailed by one to Syracuse and not out of this one by a long shot with 4:43 left in this third quarter. And it's 11-9 Loyola. Here's Ryan Wade, their leading scorer.
Good job, Maddie.
Out on top now for Carey. Look at the defense. Hesky defense by Loyola. Fine play by Stan Ross. Boy, Black graduate out of Towson, Maryland. Turning on the crowd. And a cut check delivered as the physical intensity continuing here at Evergreen Campus at Loyola College.
DeAndrea roaming out of the net, just blindsiding Derek Radabaugh on that play. Nice check. Carolina will control. Here's Stan Ross. Excellent swarming defense. Nice check right there. You see Loyola really hustling to the ball. Two and three players around it. And here's the hit. DeAndrea up high on Lutz. No foul was called.
So Rocco DeAndrea, a junior transfer from Rutgers, surprise starter today for Farm and Star Heels. Gary Lehrman started last week against Syracuse. Now watch Loyola playing aggressive defense. Langhoff, he spins clear, but you notice how the defense came at him. And the Heels look to settle things down with 3:22 left in the third, trailing by two. Star Heels out of the Atlantic Coast Conference. And they're clearing the side. Langhoff, as he tries to work clear, they're doubling up defensively. You notice they just can't make a move head on McGeaney. The late call coming up against Loyola. A shot, a score! North Carolina, fine play made by John Spears, the junior, and it's now 11-10. And a delayed call also coming up against Loyola.
Here's the goal. The foul's going to be wiped out by the goal. But here's Spears all alone hitting the Loyola defense in a tight little circle there. But no one picked up Spears, and he faked out McGeaney. Watch, no one picked him up, and McGeaney's left out to dry here. There's nothing a goalie can do about this. You'll see McGeaney come off the pipe. Spears has all day. And he scores the goal. Anytime you allow a player to camp out next to the goal like that, the goalie's really going to be helpless.
Looks like the defense may have frozen a little bit as soon as the flag was thrown in anticipation of the play stopping. But Spears, a junior and a veteran, was able to net it. And now North Carolina not enabling Loyola to open up anything more than a two-goal advantage. That's been the biggest deficit the Tar Heels have been confronted with. North Carolina's largest lead has also been 2-9-7. So we continue to seesaw here at John M. Curley Field as that shot is sent over the crossbar from in close. That was Kyle Durkee, the junior from Moncton, Maryland. Durkee has scored a goal today. Billy Wilson defensively, number 34. Langhoff. And the all-important ground ball picked up by Brendan Fry. So now, Cottle's Greyhounds, winners of 34 out of the last 39 played here, favoring the home cooking at John M. Curley Field in Baltimore. This is Kevin Lutz.
Big truck.
Freshie, number 34, has got Lux tied up. Notice Loyola inaugurating play from behind. And in contrast, North Carolina seems to like to start their offense out on top. This is Halliday. One of the few very infrequent long-range bouncing shots Loyola has tried today. This is Rattleball looking for the hat trick. He has scored two thus far. Number 27. Kind of tough angle forced by Lutz.
Lutz is such a strong attackman. He likes to come around the left side and use his body and almost take a fadeaway type jump shot in basketball. A lot of times the ball doesn't go, but occasionally he'll put it on net and it'll go. Very tough to spot that ball coming out of the stick if you're the goaltender.
Zach Thornton, who was a soccer player. He is the goaltender for a very fine Loyola soccer team. Closest man to him was Halliday, the Canadian, number 14. Think of Marischak, another Canadian who played. In North Carolina, a big close defense. Pete Murphy. This is Turnbull, the freshman. Welcome to Baltimore. Loyola picks up the loose ball. It's a 3-on-3. Effort in their leading scorer, the Greyhound. Essex Community College at Delaney High School. 11-10, Loyola. 26 seconds left in the third quarter. First game of a doubleheader. It'll be Brown versus Duke. Mance slanting in. Oh, behind the back shot. Del Halliday. With 13 seconds left, and that off-shoulder shot seems to be the vogue this season.
Well, he's a Canadian. They do that all the time in their indoor games.
He's Rattleball over to Lutz. Lutz is dumped. Some good defense by Gresci as the horn sounds, ending the third quarter from John M. Crowley Field in Baltimore, Maryland. Loyola, after a 6-6 halftime, leads by one.
It's time to get the best for your money. And now, Toyota Motor Credit offers a special new lease on the best car built in America, Toyota Camry. With a small down payment and just $259 a month, you can drive the best American family sedan. With safety features like driver and passenger side airbags. Standard. That's Toyota Camry. If you want a deal, Toyota has a great deal. The Toyota Touch Plan. See your Toyota dealer today.
For the creators of the game, it was more than competition. It was a ritual of the spirit. For those who take the game seriously, there is only one place for sticks with custom designed and engineered pockets, protective equipment, team apparel, sportswear, custom clothing, and specialty items. Ullman Sports International. Visit our extensive showroom at 7 West Aylesbury Road in Timonium. We take the game seriously.
Lacrosse Magazine is a source for men's and women's lacrosse.
Because I still love the game so much.
Because every coach should be a member.
They make things happen.
This is awesome, man. Look at that chest.
I was at that game.
Where was it?
The magazine's cool.
Loyola scoring 5 goals in the third quarter. Let's take a look at them in action.
Here's Rattleball on a feed from Heffernan.
So Loyola continue to rev it up offensively.
This is Brendan Fry making a nice play in the open field. Getting it up to Matt Dwan, and watch the long stick with this shot. Great shot, Matty Dwan. Kevin Lutz feeding the ball to Heffernan again with another assist, and there's Del Halliday on the right-handed cut.
Loyola once more. And they open up an 11-10 lead. Let's take a look at another one for the Greyhounds.
Here's Kevin Lutz, the junior out of Baltimore, driving to the net. Decides to take it himself and beats DeAndrea Lowe.
So the speed and quickness, two ingredients missing from the Loyola offense the last couple years. Back for Dave Cottle, and they lead in this one, 11-10. Off of the faceoff, racing in for Loyola. The shot is propelled wide. Well, fast break opportunity, and that was Jason Foley, the offensive-minded defenseman at 6 feet, 185, Yorktown Heights, New York native. And Loyola will now set up around Rocco DeAndrea. Dave Cottle had hoped for a single-digit game, which certainly will not be the case, as it's 11-10.
Coach Cottle had questions regarding his offensive firepower, and I think they've been answered this afternoon.
This is Brian Duffy, who's doubled up now. Freshy defensively. Next week, we'll cross 94. It'll be the defending national champion Syracuse Orange Men visiting Homewood Field to take on Johns Hopkins University. See North Carolina double teaming and forcing Loyola to give up the ball a little quicker than they may have wanted to.
Both these teams play fundamentally sound defense. They help each other out on defense. If I'm having problems with my man, I can expect help. I'm going to have a slide and a backup.
So DeAndrea, the junior goaltender, working to clear now for Dave Klarman's Tar Heels. No North Carolina team under Klarman has ever lost two games in a row. Last week, North Carolina lost to Syracuse. Now they trail by one, a young team, turning 19 out of 34 from last year's semifinal squad. And Loyola show the effects of Dave Petromulla joining the defensive crew as a coach, the All-American. And the defense has played well today against North Carolina's offense.
A lot of scrapping going on these ground balls. Every possession now is important.
These are only third quarter stats. You notice Loyola 5-4 in goal shots, 16-9. Look at faceoffs. North Carolina continues with an 8-2 advantage. Ground balls virtually even, and neither team scored on the extra man opportunities. And it is 11-10 as North Carolina, trailing by one, tries to get the equalizer with 13 minutes and 8 seconds and counting. Howard Mash along with Quinn Kesenick on lacrosse, 94. Johnny Spears, who has a goal, number 44 for North Carolina. And now North Carolina starting to inaugurate play from behind as they're clearing the side, trying to use the size and strength. Out on top, the shot, a score! North Carolina right back, and we're tied again at 11 apiece. They got to credit Johnny Spears, the junior out of Fayetteville, New York, with setting it up. And the shot propelled goalward by Kyle Durkee, the junior from Moncton, Maryland, at St. Paul's School. And we are tied once again, this time at 11.
Kyle Durkee with two goals today. Excellent look, though, by John Spears. There's Coach Farman now, tied up at 11. Both teams don't have much big game experience, so this is going to be interesting the way this fourth quarter develops.
And as we mentioned, North Carolina trailed Syracuse by one goal last week. But depth, more than anything, did them in. As Syracuse came to life with 8 straight unanswered goals, but you got to know that Dave Klarman has got to be happy over the fact Carolina has tied the count here in the fourth.
The Carrier Dome is the toughest place to play college lacrosse. Syracuse's record over the past 10 years is they have a 95%. They've only lost 3 games in the past 10 years in the Carrier Dome.
And, of course, Loyola, a record of 34-5 here at John M. Curley Field, their evergreen campus here outside of Baltimore. This is Usman Green for the Tar Heels. Matt Dwine that meets him defensively, number 12 for Loyola. This is Chris Hall, a senior out of Detroit for North Carolina, seeing his first action. Out on top, the pass was intended for Spencer Deering, a freshman number 7. Brendan Fry racing in. Here's Heffernan with a feed. The shot. The score. What a play as Kevin Lutz gives Loyola a 12-11 lead off of a Heffernan feed. It is now Loyola 12, North Carolina 11.
It's been a benchmark of quality for 25 years. Toyota Corolla, ranked among the top 10 models in initial quality by J.D. Power & Associates. And available now through a special new plan from Toyota Motor Credit Corporation. With a small down payment and just $159 a month, you can lease the best Corolla ever with driver and passenger side airbags. Standard. If you want a deal, Toyota has a great deal. The Toyota Touch Plan. See your Toyota dealer today.
1994 World Championship. Division I and Division III National Championships. What do they all have in common? Warrior Titanium Handles. The Warrior Titanium Handle dominates the field of champions when compared to aluminum. Titanium offers the best strength-to-weight ratio and has no substitute for quality and performance. If you're ready to take your game to the next level, demand the original Titanium Handle. Demand Warrior Titanium Handles. Call 1-800-968-7845.
Classic television.
Hogan's Hero.
Green Acres.
Arnold Zip. Who played him?
Nobody. He was the pig.
Remember Family Affair?
Mr. French.
I loved him.
Really?
He's attractive.
Pete, Link, Jules. Okay, Ginger or Marianne?
Ginger was a bimbo.
Marianne
or Jeannie?
Beechwood Age Budweiser.
Jeannie.
Crisp, clean, classic.
Well, it's 12-11, Loyola leading in this one with 11:07 left. Howard Mash along with Quinn Kastanek, and the game is going pretty much as you figured, you know, a seesaw game. Both teams very young, and the goaltending, especially Tim McGeaney, as we take a look at the goal scorers.
It starts off with Brendan Fry coming up with a loose ground ball. Now watch these two Carolina players take each other out right there, enabling Loyola to have a fast break. Fry controlling the ball very nicely to Duffy, to Heffernan, and to Lutz, and watch him stick this near side. Lutz really shoots the ball hard and direct. There's no patsying around. Just drills the ball home.
Sean Heffernan, although he hasn't scored a goal, has set up quite a few. And here's another angle on the shot.
Near side. The goalie's got to take away that near side pipe.
11:07 left in regulation time. Loyola leading and with possession. This is Duffy. That's Udo. Jude Collins has got Udo. Zach Thornton. Thornton certainly a player to be reckoned with. 6'2", 210 out of John Carroll, Edgewood, Maryland. Collins isolated against Udo. Duffy with 10:30 left in the fourth. Loyola leading by one. Double teaming out on top. Loyola looking pretty.
Loose ball drilled in by Derek Latibar, who gains a hat trick with that one and gives Loyola a 2-goal advantage.
Radova's fourth goal on the rebound. Take a look at that one. Here's Duffy, and he finds Lutz. Now watch, Lutz's shot will be blocked by the Carolina defense. Goes directly to Radova, seizes the opportunity, and sticks it past the end. Radova, four goals. He's a former teammate of Lutz. Both played at Boys Latin School here in Baltimore.
Under Bobby Shriver, and of course Radova hails from Towson, Maryland. And Loyola winning a faceoff. North Carolina has dominated off of the face. The fourth quarter was the main problem at the Carrier Dome last week for North Carolina. And now after scoring the equalizer, the last two goals have belonged to Loyola. And they've opened up by two, which is equaling their biggest margin so far in this one. Brian Duffy out of West Genesee in Camillus, New York. We're seen on the Empire Sports Network out of New York, as well as New England Sports Network, Sports South out of Atlanta, and Home Team Sports in the Maryland, as well as Sports Channel in New England. We want to welcome everyone to LaCrosse 94. Notice the pipes are empty. DeAndrea picks it up. A nifty one-handed grab by Ryan Wade, the senior, leading scorer for North Carolina. And now the Tar Heels put to the test. Oh, what a stunning save by McGinney. No, it went off of his stick into the net. So McGinney flashed between the pipes to no avail, and it's now 13-12 as North Carolina refuses to quit.
Ryan Wade, first team All-American, and we see why. Watch his shot. Wade loves to work the lower corner. There's no way you're going to stop him with one player. The Loyola slide comes a little too late, and McGinney can't get there. That ball trickles in the lower corner. It's a very tough save for the goalie. Watch it again. He loves his left hand, and he loves the jump shot. Here it is. High to low. McGinney got a piece of it. You can see the ball trickle in. That's a tough one. When you're a goalie and you're on that ball, you get a piece of it, and it trickles in. That hurts.
So now it's a one-goal deficit with 9:04 left in regulation time. It appeared McGinney had made the save, but it went off the stick and slowly trickled behind him. And that'll raise it for the first ball. Ground ball is so important, especially at this time. Brendan Carey letting fly. And now North Carolina with the pressure.
Down
8:41 and counting in the fourth quarter. Howard Nash along with Quint Kasenik. And McGinney way out of the plate. He's a roaming goaltender taking a chance. It's here in the fourth quarter with Loyola up by one. Empty passing, and now Loyola with an opportunity to fast break. Mark O'Brien. Derek Radebaugh has four goals for Loyola.
55.
Brian Duffy looking into a bright sunshine as he tries to put Loyola ahead by two, equaling their largest lead. Chris Hall with him defensively, number 16. Hall seen limited action, a senior out of Detroit, Michigan. O'Brien and Sanders now the matchup from behind. A lot of patience employed as Heffernan, leading scorer for the Greyhounds under 11th year head coach Dave Cottle. Six straight trips to the NCAA tournament. 15 in a row for North Carolina. Clock continues to wind, 7:13 and counting.
Seven minutes left. Coach Cottle now keeping the Carolina midfielders on the field, utilizing motion offense here. Kill some clock. They're up by one. They want to be in control of the game. They want to slow it down.
Ed O'Brien matched up now against Sanders. They clear the side. Here's O'Brien. That was well intended, but O'Brien just missed the upper right corner of the goal.
O'Brien didn't have much of an angle on that last shot. Here's the save. O'Brien comes around, but he really doesn't have much angle. DeAndrea is there, and the ball goes out of bounds. Loyola maintains possession. Loyola, they're trying to isolate against the Carolina short stick midfield. It's a lot tougher to play defense with a short stick. Loyola now trying to capitalize on that fact.
All right, here's Udo going at it against Ryan Wade. Well, Bryant continues to burn some clock. Keep an eye on 27, Derek Radebaugh. This is Kevin Lutz from behind. Lutz against Wade. Udo broke in from out on top, but the pass eluded him. 13-12, Loyola leading. And North Carolina picks up the loose ball. Greg Langhoff. Adding some offensive punch, and as he looked for somebody slanting in, he threw it away.
Big turn over there. Loyola controlled the ball in that last series for 5 minutes. Carolina scrapped for it. Langhoff got the ball, and then they turned it over quickly. That could hurt later on. Trailing by one, they need to make every opportunity a good one. They need to get a shot every time they get the ball.
5:46 left, regulation time. Now Loyola trying to clear. Jude Collins, number 42 for North Carolina. Zach Thornton, and he tried the element of surprise, but Freshie flashed between the bikes, and now Loyola breaks up the clear. You see DeAndrea come out of the net to cut down the angle. Fine play made by the North Carolina goaltender. Johnny Spears, number 44, and he sends Collins racing in. Billy Wilson on defense, number 34 for Loyola. And this time, North Carolina's going to settle it down. 13-12, 4:53 and counting. Game one of a doubleheader here at Loyola College.
Coach Klarman should put the Wades out on the field right now. They're the hot guys.
And a shot drilled wide, and the closest man to it from behind the net is Carey. Carey shut off the defensive efforts of number 8. Five. Now with a settled offense, 4:24 left. Overloading the right side. Turnbull, the freshman number 12, standing at the top of the box as they're working off the left wing. Now they clear the side. Tremendous defense by Brendan Fry. And now head coach Dave Plum has decided to call a timeout with exactly 4 minutes remaining from John M. Curley Field. It's 13-12, Loyola.
For the creators of the game, it was more than competition. It was a ritual of the spirit. For those who take the game seriously, there is only one place for sticks with custom designed and engineered pockets, protective equipment, team apparel, sportswear, custom clothing, and specialty items. Ullman Sports International. Visit our extensive showroom at 7 West Aylesbury Road in Timonium. We take the game seriously.
They're always working on something new.
That's why everyone who's serious about lacrosse plays with sticks equipment.
My mother uses a stick.
With sticks, you'll score more goals.
Probably 1,000, 100,000, 1,000,000.
The people at sticks know the sport.
The lacrosse players.
The lacrosse players. I think my brother Paul worked at sticks.
Every goal he scored with sticks.
Sure do.
Can't say any more about it.
Classic television.
Hogan's Hero.
Green Acres.
Arnold Zipper. Who played him?
Nobody. He was the pig.
Remember Family Affair?
Mr. French. I loved him.
He's
attractive.
Pete.
Link. Julie. Okay, Ginger or Marianne?
Ginger was a bimbo.
Marianne
or Jeannie?
Beechwood Age Budweiser.
Jeannie.
Crisp, clean, classic.
Howard Mash along with Quinn Cassidy. 4 minutes remaining, regulation time. Loyola leading 13-12.
There's Zach Thornton with an outside shot. DeAndrea was caught out of the net. Watch Chuck Bresci, the honorable mention All-American. makes that save in front of the empty net. Nice play by Bresci, whose brother was their first team All-American at Carolina, is now an assistant coach at Brown.
All right, here's Wade trying to work his way in. We're going to get a delayed call coming up against Loyola. The North Carolina shot just wide. That was a drive from a tough angle. And now North Carolina will have an opportunity to work with the extra man with 3:38 left in the fourth quarter, trailing in this one 13-12.
Carolina has not played very well during the man-up opportunities today. Here's the foul. It's going to be a pushing call against Brendan Fry. He pushes Jason Wade from behind. Good call made by the official who's right there. Great opportunity for Carolina to tie it up.
The North Carolina has not been opportunistic working with the extra man, and they need one now as the clock working against them. 3:32 remaining, down by a goal to Loyola. You'll watch that quick perimeter passing. Ryan Wade over to his brother and off to the left side. 19-43, the Wade brothers, the dominant forces offensively. A shot. McGeaney goes to his knees and makes the save. So in flashes of his sparkling freshman year when he was honorable mention, and a long shot. Out on top, trying to quick stick it in. So two near misses for Loyola, and North Carolina will have to clear length of field, perhaps a stride away from a magnificent breakaway for Loyola, as Derek Radabaugh looked for his fifth goal, but just took it a stride behind the pipes.
That'll hurt Loyola because Carolina controls. Watch a save by McGeaney. A big-time save here with 2 minutes left. McGeaney coming up against Jason Wade.
2:48 and counting as North Carolina trailing by one. Takes it over the midfield line. Jude Collins. And again, McGeaney as they're trying to beat him low. You notice how he flops to the ground. And a steal is made again. This is Langhoff. Double team and take it away. You got to credit Billy Wilson, the defenseman for Loyola. Part of the double team. And Loyola, Dave Petromala, the defensive coach, showing them how it's to be done. Ball is loose with 2:07 remaining. Sean Heffernan avoids. And now we got a delayed call coming up against North Carolina. You could hear the slash on the helmet from here.
That's going to be a call against Carolina. 1 minute. Slashing violation. Here it is. Watch the stick come up into Heffernan's face. It's very tough for defensemen to cover Sean Heffernan because he's so short. And he does draw a lot of fouls. You see right there, he gets it right in the chin. Here's another angle. You see Heffernan at 5'9". Gets a lot of sticks up around his head and his face and tends to draw fouls, which is a definite plus if you're wearing a white uniform.
All right, 2 minutes exactly. Now the clock starting to wind, 1:57. Loyola leading 13-12. Now North Carolina backing up defensively. And Loyola, as you notice, will be in no hurry whatsoever.
With less than 2 minutes left in the game, Loyola's got to keep the ball in the offensive box. They're leading.
This is Halliday, 1:33. Zach Thornton, Heffer. Got to watch the shifting defense. North Carolina can't afford to sit back. Look at that quick perimeter passing. DeAndrea look to double up. Heffer. Dominated the faceoff. They need a big effort from Drew Collins once again. And they come away with that all-important base. And now North Carolina with a clock against them. And a tough defensive Loyola. And a steal by Loyola. Jason only weaves his way in. And Heffernan scores a 14th goal. And now we have a whistle. And a stop.
As I said earlier, with less than 2 minutes left in the game, the team that's leading must keep the ball in the offensive box. That time, Sean Heffernan got the ball, stepped into the box, and then passed it out of the offensive box, and Carolina controls now.
Last time we were here at Curley Field, you can see right there, Heffernan steps in the box, and then realizes that he's got to keep it in the box. Last year, in the second game of Lacrosse 93, Loyola upset Syracuse, and now Loyola leading by two. Ryan Wade, leading scorer for North Carolina, with 40 seconds remaining. Tar Heels need two to send this one into overtime. This is Collins for Langhoff. Again, good defense by Billy Wilson as Langhoff. And the stick of McGeady comes up. Did you notice it flashed to the top of the post? And sent it off the side. And now, with 22 seconds left, Loyola continuing to lead by two goals. Now let's take a look at that last shot.
Let's see if McGeady gets this or it hits the pipe. I think that had him beaten, hit the pipe, but McGeady's had a great game. He's been the difference. He's made more quality saves than Rocco D'Andrea, the North Carolina goalie.
22 seconds left in regulation time. Loyola with that 14-12 lead. Here's some of the capacity crowd here at John M. Curley. Things are really on a high note here at Loyola. They're men's basketball team going to the NCAA Division I and the women's team also. And now Loyola an opportunity to open up the season 3-0 and beat the North Carolina Tar Heels, handing them their second straight defeat. First time in history of Dave Quarman as their head coach.
North Carolina's got a lot of talent, but they'll be 0-2 after this game. And since competing for the national title last year, it's been a rough road. Syracuse beat them by one goal, and last week they lost to Syracuse again. And now this week, Loyola. So they're a team in search of a new identity, and I think they'll find that. They're a quality team.
Well, of course, next game coming up today will be Duke versus Brown, the second part of this big doubleheader. And next week we'll be coming your way from Homewood Field on the campus of Johns Hopkins University as the defending national champion Syracuse Orange Men take on Tony Seaman's Blue Jays.
If you like offensive lacrosse, I think it's a must-see. Syracuse has the potential to score 25 goals against Hopkins. Last year they scored 22 against them.
Mm-hmm.
Princeton scored 20 against Hopkins. There's no reason why those Syracuse midfielders won't fill it up next week. It should be a great game to watch.
For Syracuse, after beating North Carolina, went down to sunny Florida to take on Yale. They had a week in the sun and should be fired up to take on Johns Hopkins. Blue Jays against Rutgers is trying to come in from behind with a stuff shot. It's Jude Collins, 16 and now 15 seconds. North Carolina needs a miracle. Loyola happy to have play confined to midfield. It's an open net, a shot just wide as D'Andrea, forced to gamble, left way out of the pipes. And now the crowd obviously sensing the imminent victory. 2 seconds, one, and that's it. The Loyola Greyhounds have upset the North Carolina Tar Heels, the number two ranked team in the country coming into this one. And Loyola wins it 14-12.
See the Loyola players celebrating this one. Big win for Loyola. Both teams came in with a lot of question marks, but I think they were answered today.
So Loyola moves their record out to 3 victories and no losses. And North Carolina opens up 0-2 after losing to Syracuse last week. And the final in this one, the Greyhounds 14, North Carolina 12. And we'll be back.
For the most exciting plays of the week, tune your tube to HPS's Week in Review with George Johnson as he brings you the freshest regional sports wrap-up around. That's HPS's Week in Review, Fridays at 6:30, only on HPS. Be there.
everybody. I'm Al Kokin, inviting you to join me on the Bullets Report. A half an hour before every home game here on HGS, I'll have the Bullets Report for you. We'll update you on what's going on with the Bullets, as well as the rest of the NBA. All of that from the best seat in the house. So join me for the Bullets Report on right here on HGS.
Howard Mash along with Quinn Kesenick back here at John M. Curley Jr. Field in Baltimore, Maryland. Happy to have with us the victorious head coach of Loyola College Greyhounds, Dave Cottle. Congratulations on his victory over North Carolina.
Thanks a lot, Howard.
What were the keys today, David, as you see them, and what were some of the surprises that you saw out of North Carolina?
Well, we felt we had to win faceoffs so that if we won some faceoffs, we could control the ball a little bit and make them play a lot of defense. We didn't win very many faceoffs to the end of the game. They were very athletic on ground balls. I really felt they fought and scrapped. And the key for us, we had to score some extra man goals. We knew going into it, we had to get the double figures to win. And our kids really hustled.
Well, it's got to be the fastest and quickest Loyola team that I've seen in the last 3 years. So it's got to put a smile on your face.
Well, we are a little more athletic. I don't know if we have the skills of some of the teams that we've had in the past. I do know one thing, that defensively, even though we gave up 12 goals, our goalie and our defense is pretty solid. And they worked hard. And Carolina put a lot of pressure on us, but we didn't wilt.
Coach, you did a great job stopping the Wade brothers, Ryan and Jason. What were the keys behind stopping them?
Well, Quint, as we talked this morning a little bit, we just couldn't let those guys have five or six goals. I don't even know how many they had. I think they might have had a couple. But we had to stop them and try to stop John Spears and June Collins, and we felt they were their key players. And I'm not sure we stopped them, but we limited them to not as many goals as we got.
So head coach Dave Cottle in his 12th year as a head coach. Congratulations, a big victory. And Loyola now with a 3-0 record. We'll be back with the most valuable player, Derek Radabaugh, right after this.
Introducing the ultimate pepperoni pizza, new from Pizza Hut.
Maybe we shouldn't eat this. What?
Zesty herbs, thicker pepperoni for a whole new taste.
It's the ultimate. We eat this now and it could ruin everything else. It's like you go out with a supermodel. Some girls would be nothing. Susan Myers would be okay. But no, a supermodel. One bite. There's no going back. So you gonna eat it?
Yeah.
Try one for $8.99. A second medium for $5 more.
It's been a benchmark of quality for 25 years.
Just simply the best!
Toyota Corolla. Ranked among the top 10 models in initial quality by J.D. Power & Associates. And available now through a special new plan from Toyota Motor Credit Corporation. With a small down payment and just $159 a month, you can lease the best ever with driver and passenger side airbags. Standard. If you want a deal, Toyota has a great deal. The Toyota Touch Plan. See your Toyota dealer today.
Loyola victorious 14-12, and one of the big reasons, Derek Radabaugh, most valuable player today. Congratulations, Derek. You had 4 goals, 1 assist, and, of course, you attended Boys Latin in Baltimore and Maryland. And how do you reflect on this one against the fine Tar Heel team?
We came out, played real hard, probably one of definitely the toughest game of the season. We had a good week of practice, and I think it showed today.
Derek, you guys seem to be improving. Over the course of the season, you start off slow in your scrimmages, and now you guys are really clicking. You're a young team. What were your expectations coming into this game?
Our defense is really solid. We worked in practice with a lot of pressure and everything. We just thought we were going to do well, and we did well today.
Derek Radabaugh, coming into this one, there were certain things that head coach Dave Cottle had hoped to accomplish. What are some of the surprises that you saw when you got out on the field against North Carolina?
We were expecting a lot of pressure. When we came out, we handled the pressure pretty well. They're a very athletic team, but I think we prepared really well this week.
How does this Carolina team compare to the team you played last year?
Very athletic, like I said before. I think they have room to improve, but I think they're definitely going to be in the playoffs. They're going to be a really good team down the road, I think.
Derek Radabaugh, the most valuable player, graduate of Boys Latin, and it's going to be the Radabaugh Show. As we go to break here, we're going to see 3 of your goals on this Radabaugh highlight film.
Mm-hmm.
For the creators of the game, it was more than competition. It was a ritual of the spirit. For those who take the game seriously, there is only one place for sticks with custom designed and engineered pockets, protective equipment, team apparel, sportswear, custom clothing, and specialty items. Ullman Sports International. Visit our extensive showroom at 7 West Aylesbury Road in Timonium. We take the game seriously.
You want the best for your money.
You're simply the best.
And now you can drive a dependable Toyota Tercel at a bargain price. With a small down payment, you can lease a Toyota Tercel for just $129 a month through a special new plan from Toyota Motor Credit Corporation. You get Tercel quality and value with the security of front-wheel drive and the safety of a driver's side airbag. So if you want a deal, Toyota has a great deal. The Toyota Touch Plan. See your Toyota dealer today.
John M. Crowley Field, the site of a terrific game. Neither team, Loyola nor North Carolina, held more than a two-goal advantage throughout the entire game. And Quint Cassidy.